Hamilton River Band.
Mr. Speaker, there's no excuse why they can't share that information right here in the House. We shouldn't have to wait outside in the press conference to hear that information. Because right just today, we've heard that the minister from the other side of the wave, and the health minister, told that Canadians that the first individual identified with the coronavirus didn't self-identify when entering Canada. On Monday, we learned that the individual did tell the CBSA officer he'd been to Wuhan and did have a cough. There's no question that this raises concern between CBSA and health officials when China has seen a 65% increase in reported cases in just one day. How can Canadians be sure that the current screening measures are working?
The Honourable Minister of Health.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. In fact, the individual that the member opposite is referring to and took exactly the appropriate precautions that were that he was given at the border. So, for example, he returned to his home. He began to exhibit symptoms. He phoned for emergency help. He let the emergency responders know that he had recently traveled to Wuhan. They arrived in protective gear. They alerted the hospital to which he was being transported. The appropriate infection protections were taken. He was isolated. Mr. Speaker, this gives me confidence that, in fact, the system is working very well together.
The Honourable Member for Richmond Athabasca. Mr. Speaker, the impact of the coronavirus is growing. 25 people are currently under observation, and we know that the virus is spreading faster than originally thought. The number of people infected has increased by 65%. We also know that the first two cases detected in Canada came from passengers on flight CZ311, which had hundreds of people on board. Mr. Speaker, does the government know where all of those passengers are right now? Honourable Minister of Health.
Because of the collaboration that I mentioned earlier, my colleagues in Ontario and all across the province have been working extremely well to share information. In the case that he references, we immediately provided the airplane manifest, which allowed the contact tracing to begin. In fact, Ontario has been contacting the passengers that may have been infected, and it's done so exceedingly well. I have every confidence that my colleagues across the province and territories are taking their responsibilities as seriously as we are, and I want to thank them for doing so.